Hey, thanks for checking out the True False Equations Calculator video from MathCelebrity.com. In the next 2 to 3 minutes, I'm going to show you a simple three-step process to solve any true false equation problem. So let's walk through two examples today. We're going to start in the calculator here by doing 3 as an example. 3 plus 2 equals 4 plus 1. And we're going to hit return. And we're going to walk through and see how we do this. So as you can see, true-false equations use a three-step process. And what we want to do is check if the value on the left side of the equation is equal to the value on the right side of the equation. If they are equal, then the equation is true. If they are not equal, then the equation is false. So let's walk through our three-step true-false equation process. On the left side of the equation, we have 3 plus 2. That evaluates to 5. Step 2, the right side of the equal sign, is 4 plus 1, which gives us 5. And finally, the last step of the true-false equation, we want to compare the left side to the right side. Since they're equal, since 5 equals 5, then the true-false equation 3 plus 2 equal to 4 plus 1 is true. Now let's take one more example of a true-false equation. We're going to do 4 plus 2 equals 5 minus 1. Hit return, and let's go through our three-step process again. Step 1, we're going to evaluate the left side of the equal sign. That's 4 plus 2, which gives us 6. Step 2, we evaluate the right side of the equal sign. 5 minus 1 gives us 4. And in step 3, we want to compare the left side to the right side and see if they match. Since 6 does not equal 4, then the true-false equation is false. So this is a simple three-step process you can always use to identify if true-false equations are true or false. Just to reiterate, step 1, evaluate the left side of the equation. Step 2, evaluate the right side of the equation. And finally, step 3, compare them. If they both equal each other, it is true. If they don't equal each other, it is false. So that's it, my friends. That is true-false equations in three steps. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.